Here we are with one of my Saraki 2-minute talks, all about shoulder pain. Shoulder pain tends to come on insidiously. Often you notice that it's painful to lie on that side in bed, a sort of deep gnawing ache in the shoulder. It makes you want to squeeze it and pummel it. You also start to notice that it's difficult getting a coat on, getting your hand to the top of your head, getting your hand behind your back. Now, first of all, let me show you a little bit about the anatomy of the shoulder. Here it is. It's a very loose joint, a very what we call a flail joint. It's floppy. It sacrifices stability for mobility. Here's the ball and socket. Here's a very shallow little cup here. Here's the head of the humerus, the upper arm bone. It sort of skids around on that. Under this ledge, incidentally, which is made from the clavicle, the collarbone, joining here with the spine of the scapula at the back. And this is implicated very strongly in developmental disorders of the shoulder, in turn caused by using the arm badly to start with. I'll go on to explain that. So the arm is a very long lever. It is a bit of a tall order to make the arm work properly. But to help give you that tremendous flamboyant mobility of the arm, you have a mobile base provided by your shoulder blade or scapula. Here's the ledge. Here's the head of the humerus here. Now, these are the rotator cuff muscles. These are at the front, growing off the front of the scapula. This is the back. They wrap around the neck of the humerus here and insert into here. They twist the arm, they lift the arm, they do all sorts of things. But if there's problems in the mobility between arm bone and scapular bone, that means that the union is too tight, then you start to develop problems. In particular, what tends to happen is that the shoulder becomes not stable enough. The scapula should be very, very firmly attached and controlled on the back of the chest wall, so that when you go to use the arm, the scapula doesn't scoot along too and join in and come along too. It shouldn't do that, and if it does do that, then you tend to get fraying up here under the ledge of the shoulder blade. Now, neck problems can also have an influence on the way you work the arm, the way you use the arm. Simply speaking, it can cause your neck muscles to go into overactive mode. In addition, and included in that is your upper fibres of trapezius here. And what happens when the upper fibres overwork, the lower fibres underwork, so that the shoulder wings like this. Now, when the shoulder blade isn't stable, then the arm bone tends to bump up under this ledge and fray through. Here we see it again with lots of people doing exercises for the shoulder. What the fitness industry needs to understand is that when teaching people to lift, that there should stay down, otherwise she's fraying through here. Now, you'll see in the exercises that I'm about to show you that a lot of the exercises are to do with stretching that very gummed up over strong union between arm bone and shoulder blade. So I'm giving you stretches for that. I'm also giving you exercises that make the shoulder blade stabilization, meaning the scapula, the shoulder blade, much more stable against the back wall of the chest, so that when you lift your arm, the shoulder blade doesn't come along too. So here we go.